Make sure you watch this video entirely before buying your next Windows laptop. So a small hint about this topic. So remember how smartphone manufacturers removed removable batteries from our smartphones? It's kind of like that. So without wasting any precious time, let's begin. If you're someone who follows the tech world, you know that few years back, Apple started soldering the RAM and storage into their devices, so it was not user upgradable. And this was a move to increase the profits in many ways, but that's for another video. Now, of course, that's Mac, and you know, people who were into the Mac ecosystem initially didn't like it, but as time went on, they got adapted to it, and right now, you know, people buy whatever configuration they want beforehand, use it for a good amount of time and then sell it or, you know, change it. But okay, that's with Mac. But the thing with Windows laptop was that, you know, it was the ease, the peace of mind that you can upgrade, or, you know, you could, you know, change something by yourself if anything went wrong. And in this case, it's about the RAM and the storage. Of course, few years back when, you know, Windows PC manufacturers wanted to make ultra thin laptops, they of course had to solder things into the motherboard, and that was fine. And of course, those were expensive and not many people bought them. And the masses, you know, buy laptops which are priced between, you know, 30,000 and say at the max 60-65,000 rupees. And the thing that is kind of concerning right now is that the same thing which Apple did with its MacBooks, the same thing has started. I mean, it's not completely, you know, in full flow, but it has started to happen for Windows laptops, and not the expensive ones, but the ones that, you know, you and I will, you know, end up buying. Now, that is a bit of a concern here, especially if you can't upgrade your RAM and storage. Now, I'll talk about why it is a disadvantage. But before that, here are, you know, few laptops I found that are not good for upgrading or serviceability. On the screen, I'll be showing two or three laptops. Now, one is from Asus and two are from Lenovo. Now, if you take a look at all the three, they don't have upgradable RAM. Now, all the RAM here is soldered onto the motherboard. And the next thing that you will notice is that there's only a single SSD slot. Yes, a single slot. Now that I have shown you, you know, some real examples, let's get into its disadvantages. So first, let's talk about RAM. Now with soldered RAM, there is a lot of problem. So the main thing you need to understand is if RAM gets, you know, corrupted or damaged, there are many things that will happen. Like, you know, the blue screen of death, like many people call, you get random reboots, you know, the performance gets hit, and of course there might be data loss. Now, if you have user upgradable or user serviceable RAM, the main advantage is that you can actually check what's going on with your RAM. Now, if your RAM is, you know, faulty, you can easily switch it out, and you can, you know, put in a new one and you are good to go. But when it comes to soldered RAM, it is tough. Number one, it is not easy, you know, fixing, you know, soldered RAM. It is hard. You will have to go to, you know, your company's service centers to fix that. And I don't know how good they are with doing this, because they usually replace your laptops. And of course, since there's no guarantee and your laptop might be replaced, you know, taking the data or erasing it, you know, your workflow, your day-to-day work with your laptop will definitely get affected, and that is not good. Now, even in terms of upgradability, this is a huge disadvantage. Now, say your processor supports, say, up to 32 gigs of RAM, but you're limited only to 16, and all the 16 are, you know, soldered onto the motherboard and there's no, you know, extra RAM slot, then yeah, you are stuck with 16, and later down the road, you will have to upgrade. But how much RAM in a laptop is decided by the manufacturer, and with this, you get a shorter lifespan on your laptop. With that said, these are, you know, three major disadvantages of having soldered RAM. With that, let's shift our focus towards storage. Now, in all the three laptops that I've showed you, and many more available online, you will notice that there's only a single storage slot. Now, usually there used to be two. One will be occupied and another will be free. Of course, you will still find that in gaming laptops, but even in normal day-to-day laptops, that was available. But now it's only a single slot, you know, storage solution, and that is not good. Now, say you want to upgrade your storage, and you buy a new SSD. But the thing is, you'll have to remove the old one and put the new one, and that includes a lot of file transferring. Now you have to transfer files from the old one to an SSD, and then, you know, put in the new one and then transfer to this. So it's a lot of work, and not everyone are interested in doing that. If you have another slot, it's just put it in easy, format it, and you're good to go. But this is not a great solution, because a lot of time will get waste, you know, in transferring files and things like that. Now, if you compare the situation of storage with RAM, it's nothing that bad. At least you do have removable SSDs. But when it comes to RAM, it's bad. It's bad, and I've seen this going on with a couple of laptops recently. Now, the main reason why I think laptop manufacturers do this, it's actually not think, it is a move to make sure they are profitable. Say if your RAM is soldered, you bring in your laptop, they try to repair it, they can charge higher because, you know, the actual procedure to fix that will definitely be high. If you can't do that, you'll, you know, just sell it or buy a new one. So you are going to be a customer who's going to be coming back. And even without your knowledge, if you like that company, you might end up buying a new laptop from them once this is, you know, completely gone bad. Now, I do remember my old Dell laptop, which was used for, say, like 8 years. I mean, I thought the lifespan of it would be only like 4 years or so, but I did upgrade the RAM from a hard disk. I did put in SSD, and it worked for like 3 or 4 more years. And I have to say, the experience was good once I upgraded to an SSD. But right now, even if you can do it with the SSD, you can't upgrade the RAM. So multitasking isn't going to be as easy as you think with just 8 gigs of soldered memory. But even though all this is happening, this is not happening in a large scale. Only very few newer laptops are being, you know, put into this new soldered RAM territory. And there are laptops that you can still buy which have upgradeable RAM and upgradeable storage. There are even laptops which have a single soldered, you know, RAM stick, and there's another free slot where you can put 8 or 16 gigs. You know, things like that are really, really good. But if this trend continues, say within 3 years or so, you will find laptops, like say 60 to 70% of laptops with soldered memory. And it will be mostly in everyday work laptops, and that is not good. Here's my takeaway. So if you don't mind about, you know, non-upgradable storage, or if you're someone who will, you know, just change a laptop once it goes bad, then this should not be a problem for you. But if you're someone who, you know, is very keen on having, you know, good upgradability and serviceability of your laptop, then this is not the one for you. So before buying your next laptop, make sure you check all this, be it offline or online. Please make sure you check all of this. With that said, thanks for watching. And this here is Suman signing off once again. Catch you later.